folks. What are we doing today? We're doing automotive electrical. We're starting a series to explain and make it simple for you. Come on, let me show you what I have. Take a look down here. I'm going to start off with my motor devices. Starter motor, blower motor, fuel pump motor. This one's a little actuator motor that goes on the air conditioning system. We have motors. We have motors, we have clutch coils, we have ignition coils, we have injectors, we have relays. We have relays. There are 6 electrical devices on the vehicle. Devices, 5 of them fall into one particular category. The 5 that I'm about to mention all are electromagnetic devices. And I'm going to make sure you understand what electromagnetism is. I'm not just going to say it. I'm going to show you. That's my specialty, showing you how things work. All right? Here, motors, solenoids, ignition coils, clutch coils, and relays. All of these devices that I have on the table, let's take another look at it. Every single one of these devices on the table, besides my meter and booster, are all electromagnetic devices. Electromagnetic. Have you figured out which electrical device I'm leaving out? The lighting. I'm going to leave the lighting out because it's not electromagnetic, but I want you to understand. Electromagnetism. I'm fascinated. I've always been fascinated by magnets, even as a child. To me, magnets are magic. All of these devices, every single one that's on this table, work electromagnetically. So let's go pick the best one to emphasize what I mean. In this particular case, I'm going to get this one. This is out of an air conditioning clutch coil. This is a magnetic device. All of these are electromagnetic devices. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little booster. It's amazing what these do. I can start a car with just this and no other battery in sight. This is nothing more than a 12-volt battery. Now, in my first episode of electrical, I tried to convince you that you're not going to get electrocuted. 12 volts, if you remember, go watch that one. 12 volts is not going to electrocute you, but it will burn you. So I'm not trying to pull a fast one. I'm taking 12 volts. I'm going to show you what I do. I remember still, just like the other day, here's what I would do. I would grab the students, about a dozen of them. We'd go to the work table. I'd get some motivation out. I'd take this little motivation. I'd put it right on here. Take a look right here. I put the $20 right there. I put the clutch coil right there. And then I would take 12 volts. I would take 12 volts and I would hook it up. Now, right now, this is not electromagnetic. It's not. This can easily be lifted up. Okay? Can you figure out where I'm going with this, folks? I'm not afraid of 12 volts, but I'm going to show you a few more things. I'm very comfortable connecting the positive and connecting the negative. Let me show you one more time. This is not magnetized at all. Okay, here we go. I'm going to connect that. And when I push this button right there, all of a sudden it becomes a strong magnet. And I would tell the students, come on, come on. I say, all right, who wants to go first? Who wants to try to pull that magnet off and you get the $20? Well, they go up there, they're pulling and huffing and puffing, and I'm over there calling them a wuss and a wimp. But let me show you, come back on down. I've got the scale that I can measure. Most of my students know I'm a measuring fool. Give him a measurement and he'll figure it out for you. Okay, I'm gonna turn this on. I'm gonna make sure you believe me. This is an electronic scale. I'm not pretending. I'm going to prove to you that that becomes an incredibly strong, strong magnet. My unit of measurement, let it zero out. Here we go. Right now, it's not magnetized, but when I push that button, there it is. I come in here, and I get ready to take a measurement. And I pull, and I pull, and I pull, and I pull. Now, this scale's got 100-pound weight on it. All right? Now, the guy's never Never were able to get that $20. Now, when that little timer on that battery goes off, it's just going to fly off of here. This is electromagnetism. When I say electromagnetism, I want you to think about this magnet that I'm showing you how powerful it is. The battery set off the timer, little safety feature. But for years and years and years, nobody. And they tried their best. I had one big diesel guy, he bled. And no, he wasn't able to do that. When I say electromagnetism, I want you to think of this little demonstration. All right, now that I have your attention, come on. Right over here. I just showed you a good working clutch coil. This one works, all right? One of my favorite parts of working on these cars and having the students take it apart. This one here, this is what electrical's about. It doesn't look bad. It's not like a brake shoe or tire or oil leak. It doesn't look bad, but it is. Let me show you what's wrong with this one. Right over here. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take my booster pack. I'll connect one, I'll connect the other, and I'll push the button. And my little light should come on. I push the button, my light is on, I have 12 volts, and I'm not trying to pull a fast one on you, folks. I'm doing exactly what I did on that first one. I connected it. I turned the battery on. It worked. Here, what's the difference? Well, this is bad. There's only two ways for electrical devices to go bad. And this one is the most common. This is called an open circuit. An open circuit means lack of contact. Somewhere in the winding, more than likely, where the multi-strands connects to the inner winding, it has come unsoldered. This is an example of a faulty device. This is a very common one. All right, got one more for you. I hope I have your attention. I showed you the one that works. And then I showed you, well, this one is open. Let me show you this one. All right? Sure enough, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to connect one. Nothing's going to happen until I push that button. So I'm going to connect the next one. Of course, nothing's happening but right now. But let's see what happens when I push that button. Whoa! What happened? It sparked and disconnected. Well, let's try it again. If I try to connect this, No, I didn't get electrocuted. It's just part of the fun that I'm having. There was a big spark. This guy represents the second fault that occurs. There's only two ways for electrical devices to mess up. They're either gonna go open because they're lacking contact, or they're going to go shorted because of unwanted contact. Now, there's no moving parts here, or is there? Now, wait a minute, I can see something very suspicious on this particular one. I didn't rig it up, they mess up by themselves. When I looked at it a little closer, I could see overheating. Apparently, the clutch, the hub, the compressor was overheating, it overheated the clutch coil, it melted the insulation. What insulation am I talking about? Well, let's take a look. Let's go inside a DC motor. Okay, I'm just getting started. I don't want to make it too long because I want you to understand every little bit part of this thing. This is an average DC motor. I'll just move the brushes, okay, and I'm going to take this guy out. This one is called an armature. You can see the copper windings. This is where the electromagnetism is created, just like this. If you go into any of these devices, you're going to have what's called windings. And these windings serve one purpose. The purpose of the windings, whether they be in the coil, in the motor, the solenoid, the relay, the ignition coil, I don't care which one it is, all of these devices work off electromagnetism, and the winding provides us with that. Can you see the copper? Sure you can. Can you see the insulation on the copper? Does it have insulation? Yes, it does. But the insulation, these windings, they're not supposed to be touching each other, and there's supposed to be an insulation, and there is, but after time and some heat, the insulation melts and it makes what's called an unwanted contact. What does that mean? Now we have a short circuit. The opposite of a short circuit is when the brushes wear out. Here, where is it? Right here. I think you might be able to see. This commutator is worn. And yes, these brushes are worn. When you don't make contact, it's called an open. When you have an unwanted contact, it's called a short. One, no electricity moves, and the other one, too much electricity moves. Okay, folks, here is lesson number two. Lesson number one was don't be afraid of them 12 volts, but you're going to be careful what you're doing. Lesson number two in the beginning of our electrical is understanding electromagnetism and how it's used so much in so many devices. Again, there are 6 devices, and the majority of them are all electromagnetic. And I think you have a good idea. When I say electromagnetic, I mean electromagnetic. The last one is the lighting. Lights, they don't work off electromagnetism. Come back to the next show and you'll understand how that works. And then we're going to go to electrical protection. That means you know all the steps and the moves and you look good while you're doing it. I hope you learned something today, folks. I hope you keep coming back. And you know what I like. Comments. I like thumbs up. I like comments. And sure, if you want to help me out a little bit, hit that subscribe button.